Prime Minister Narendra Modi's support to people of Balochistan, POK and Gilgit-Baltistan in his Independence Day speech finds immediate echo. Activists from these regions hail the PM's speech, say it will strengthen their struggle against atrocities of the Pak establishment. Prime Minister Modi hits out at Pakistan for glorifying terrorists, says Pakistan's double standards on terrorism stand exposed, asserts that both countries need to fight poverty and work for the economic growth. In Jammu and Kashmir, five militants were killed in an operation as the army foiled a major infiltration bid near the line of control in Uri sector in Baramulla district. Meanwhile, two terrorists were also killed in an encounter with security forces in downtown Srinagar. Pramod Kumar, commandant of the 49th Battalion of the Central Reserve Police Force, attained martyrdom in the operation. More than 260 kilograms of gold worth 180 crore rupees is missing from the vault of famous Padmanabh Swami Temple of Kerala. The sensational revelations comes in the report of former CAG in his report to the Supreme Court. The report said 30% of the gold sent for melting and purification was lost. Price of petrol was cut by 1 rupees per litre and diesel by 2 rupees per litre, the fourth reduction in rate since July. Petrol will now cost 60 rupees a litre in Delhi as compared to 61 rupees a litre currently. The price of diesel will cost 50 rupees per litre as against 52 rupees. The price was last cut by 1 rupee 42 paise a litre in case of petrol and 2 rupee 1 paise per litre for diesel on 1st of August. In Bihar, the special session of the state legislature is being held today to ratify the Constitution Amendment Bill on Goods and Services Tax. The session will be for one day only. Bihar is the first non-BJP-ruled state to convene session to give its consent to GST. It may be noted that both the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha had passed the GST bill recently. In Nepal, an overcrowded bus veered off on a mountain highway, killing at least 33 people and injuring 28. The bus veered off Orniko Highway and rolled about 150 meters. Army and police rescuers were combing the slopes near Deroli village, 80 kilometers east of Kathmandu. Police were still trying to determine the cause. The highway is wide enough for two vehicles to pass but has sharp turns and no guardrails. Russian Defense Minister has said that Russia and United States are close to starting joint military action against militants in Syria's Aleppo. Russian Defense Minister said that both the countries are at a very active phase of negotiations. Fighting for control of the divided city of some 2 million people has intensified in recent weeks. There have been some gains for rebel groups battling Syrian government forces. Republican presidential hopeful Donald Trump unveiled his anti-terrorism plan, saying he would implement extreme vetting of immigrants and suspend immigration from certain countries to protect the United States. In a policy speech in the swing state of Ohio, the billionaire real estate mogul, who is vying with Hillary Clinton for the White House, vowed to crush and destroy the ISIS group, accusing Clinton and President Barack Obama of allowing it to grow. The Nigerian army said its troops have thwarted a Boko Haram attack in the country's volatile northeast, killing 16 insurgents while 12 soldiers were wounded. A cache of arms and ammunition were recovered from the insurgents. A counter-offensive spearheaded by Nigeria since January last year has recaptured swaths of territory lost to the Islamic State militants in 2014. In Yemen, an Arab coalition air raid hit a hospital, killing at least 11 people and injuring more than 19, just 48 hours after strikes that killed children. The explosion immediately killed 9 people, while 2 more patients died while being transferred to another clinic. The Arab coalition, led by Saudi Arabia, began its campaign of airstrikes against Iran-backed Houthi rebels and their allies on March 2015. Torrential rains in Moscow beat a 129-year-old record for the heaviest August downpours, the state weather service said. Moscovites splashed through flooded streets after more than 48 millimeters of rainfall hit the city, nearly double the previous maximum recorded back in 1887. Emergency services said they had rescued some 80 people trapped in their cars and a bus on a flooded street in southern Moscow. A wildfire that spread into a small northern California town over the weekend destroyed more than 175 homes and businesses, even as crews fought to save more dwellings from the flames. The Clayton Fire, named for the creek near where it broke out, was driven by fierce winds into the foothill community of Lower Lake. The fire has forced hundreds of residents to flee. In Rio Olympics, good performances by badminton players keeps afloat medal hopes. PV Sindhu and Kidambi Srikanth enter quarterfinals. Boxer Vikas Krishnan loses to his Uzbek rival in the quarterfinal bout. According to NASA, the Earth just broiled its hottest month in recorded history, even after the fading of a strong El Nino, which spikes global temperatures on top of man-made climate change. July burst global temperature records. NASA calculated that July 2016 was 1.51 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than the 1950 to 1980 global average.